Asbury Park is undergoing a massive redevelopment. Once the jewel of the Jersey Shore, the town was largely abandoned and slipped into ruins in the 1970s and 80s. Now, the boardwalk is full of visitors, the famous music venues are crowded, and the galleries and restaurants are packed. Public art is also booming.
Say you're coming here to see a show, chances are, depending on the show you come to see, you might engage in the local arts scene, whether that be coming to a gallery or walking on the boardwalk and seeing, you know, murals and stuff. So I think that when you come here, those people create an energy too. So you're like, oh, that person's different. I don't see that person in my daily life. Like, well, this is an artsy town. Then all of a sudden it's like, wow, Asbury Park is a destination for the arts.
There's been a lot of development, and it's been good. At the time when I came here on Cookman, there was probably like 3 or 4 stores. Now there's bars and restaurants and glass blowing, artisanal pizza, and you can't find a place to park anymore. And that's all a good thing, because it's bringing people here. There's more interest. You know, it's a developing city.
Jen Hampton runs the Parlor Gallery and organized a mural project on the boardwalk last summer.
So we thought it'd be really cool to say, hey, let's have a party for the murals that happened all summer, because people have been engaging in it, whether that be through like pictures or watching the artists work. So it's been a very cool thing this summer to see evolve, because they're like, oh, there's a mural this week. There's another mural next week.
Graphic artists and designers Ed Johnson and Mike Richeson used a smartphone app to create a virtual tour of Asbury's past. As you walk around the city, you can see past structures superimposed on the camera of your phone.
So we're using an app called Junio, and the way it works is that you download this app from your store, and it's manufactured in Germany. So you click on this, and then you hit the scan button and you scan this barcode that's on these cards that we distributed all around Asbury. You hold your phone up and you see the carousel, for example, popping up right in place where it used to be.
Right out here in the water is where the SS Moreau Castle actually beached itself in the early 1930s. It was on its way back from Cuba to New York City.
What's great about Mike's app is that you can actually see what was once there. Because you can see the echoes of it now. And then he's mixing technology with art and history. It's pretty cool.
Mike Porkchop Lavelle is one of the most prolific mural painters in town.
The piece I did on Asbury Lanes was a woman holding this lighthouse. And the whole idea was like, she represents Asbury, and she's holding this beacon, calling people in and calling people back.
It seems that 10 years ago when I would ask artists to show here, they're like, where are you? Where now they're like, oh yeah, I heard of Asbury Park because my friend's in a band and he plays the Stone Pony or Asbury Lanes, or oh yeah, Bruce Springsteen's from there, or hey, that's where that place of that Moreau Castle crashed into, you know. So there are these like little weird tidbits that put Asbury Park on the map sort of globally, so it's been easier to get artists to work here. To me, there's this romantic past to it. You know, to read the history of Asbury Park and all the musicians that played here and all the clubs that were here and all the people that would flock here even to the beach. So from a visual point of view, we have this beautiful architecture that I hope someone preserves. You walk through Convention Hall and I just picture like what it must have been like.
Tonight I'm gonna take that ride, cross the river to the Jersey side.
Asbury Park is still figuring out who it is, but it's on a trajectory to be a place where arts and culture are ascendant.
'Cause down the shore, everything everything's all right. You and your baby on a Saturday night. Now you know all my dreams come true.
The New Jersey State Council on the Arts, encouraging excellence and public engagement in the arts since 1966, is proud to co-produce State of the Arts with Stockton University, New Jersey's distinctive public university. Additional support is provided by the Geraldine R. Dodge Foundation,